Hi, this is Ed with Fax Authority, and in this video, we're going to be covering how to send a fax with eFax's messenger system. There's three ways to send a fax with eFax: through email, through the web interface, and through the messenger system. For those other videos, as well as our full review on eFax, see our page faxauthority.com/eFax. I'm going to go over this twice. First version is going to be how to do it really quickly, just to see how quick and easy this is. There's not a whole lot of steps involved. The second version is going to be more in-depth, where we'll go through all the functions, features, and options involved in sending a fax. So what we need to do if we want to send a fax with the messenger system is open up the program, click on Send a Fax. From here, we just need to put in information such as who we're sending it to. We need to add a little bit of information to our cover page. Select any files we want to attach to this. In this case, I have a Word document, a spreadsheet, and a picture that we're sending. This will attach all three of these, and as soon as we're done that, all we need to do is just click on Send Fax. And that will send our fax off right away. There's not a whole lot involved. It's really just a simple way of doing this. Now, if we have a whole lot more information we want to put in, or if we want to look at some of the options, we'll take a look at that now. So if we're looking to send a fax, obviously we just go back into the messenger system, click on Send Fax again, and now we have a whole lot of options here. So first of all, under 2, we can select this to come from our messenger address book or also our Outlook address book. So if we have all of our contacts stored into our Outlook, we can then pull it through into the system right here. We can also pull this by group, by individuals, create new individuals, and also drop them into our address books. If we have someone we want to put in here, we can enter their information in. It might have already been stored. And if we want to send this to multiple people, we could also do so as well. So we can put as many people, we can put multiple people in to have this fax sent. We can fax a copy to ourselves, and then we have other options here. So for example, if we have multiple accounts, we can choose the account that we want to send from. We can save this fax and bring it back later. We can print a copy that we have. We can also cut, copy, and paste. We can insert the files that we want. So just like at the bottom, there's those options to insert files. We can do it up here. We can look at our address book. We can choose a different cover page that we want. We can also choose the fax quality, so quicker transmission or better quality. We can add a reference number. So this could be some number that we use for a purchase order or a billing code or a reference code. And we can also look at the different settings here. So there's fax options, so what we can use for our address book. Choose the email account that we're using to fax to send and receive. We can select email software that we're using. So if we're using, for example, Thunderbird or America Online or some other sort of email program, we can set that up here. And we can also choose our scan options. So the other neat thing about eFax Messenger, and I'll show you this in a minute, is that we can send a fax directly from our scanner. So we don't need to look at this now. However, it's something that I will show you in just a few minutes. Once we have all this together, we can also choose to edit the cover page. So the information we put in here will be transferred over to the information on the receiving end. Right now, the cover page I have is a picture of a pen. If, for example, I want to change it, I can have a different cover page put onto here. And now all this information is transferred over. What happens is that eFax pulls all the information from who we're sending it to put it onto the cover page. So we don't have to go through and edit the cover page for each person. It just has it automatically transferred over to the sections of the cover page. I'll go over how to change cover pages and edit them in a separate video. But once you have them edited, you can just come back and go ahead and use that cover page right away. And then we just have our attachments down here. If we want, we can see bigger thumbnails. We can delete them from here. We can print them to see if we want to check them. We can remove them, do whatever we want. And when we're done, all we have to do is just click Send Fax, and this will send the fax automatically. The other really neat thing about the eFax Messenger system is we can send a fax directly from our scanner. So if we're used to using a walk-up fax machine, where we go up, we drop the document in, we put in a few numbers, and we hit Send, this is the closest thing to it. So we can pull the document directly from our scanner and in through eFax's system. So I'll show how to do that right now. So all we need to do is go into eFax Messenger, select Scan and Fax, and now we have the instructions to load the document into the automatic document feeder. There's a few modes here, Basic, Advanced, and Auto Scan. I'm just going to go with Basic, select Document Source, and hit Scan. So now the system is scanning the document. And once it's been scanned, I just have to hit finish scanning. And now we can preview the document, and we can see what came through on the scan. And there's all of our information there. And now we can just click on fax, and we can go ahead and we can send this just like we would any other fax or any other document. So everything works the same way sending it, but what it does now is it lets us scan it directly in, fax it out. So this way we don't have to go through that cumbersome process of scanning the file, saving the file, and then faxing the file. We can just get it directly from the fax machine and send it out. It's a good way if you're used to using a fax machine and you're looking for the easiest way to transfer over to using an online fax service. And that's a review of how we can use eFax's messenger service to send a fax. To see how this fax looks on the receiving end, and also for more on eFax, see our page at faxauthority.com/eFax.